Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I went to Trader Joe's for the very first time. All right, if you're new here, hi, I'm Claire, welcome to my channel. Normally I'm more of an Aldi girl, and if you're not new here, you probably already know that. However, everyone seems to love Trader Joe's. It has such a cult following. That I had to finally go and give it a try. I don't live near one. I had to drive like an hour and a half, but my sister and I made a day of it. We went on a Trader Joe's date, and I decided to film a little haul for you in case A, you have also never been to Trader Joe's and you want to see what's up with that. B, you want to know some of the prices at the local Trader Joe's, because I will be giving you prices, but also, if you are a Trader Joe's fan, you might just be curious to see what I found at Trader Joe's that I decided looked like a good deal and I decided to buy. All right, the first thing I'm gonna start with are these pita bites. They are the Trader Joe's brand multi-grain pita crackers, whole wheat and flaxseed. They were $2.49, a pretty average price. I know I can get something similar at Aldi for a lot cheaper, but they looked good and I wanted these especially because, guys, their cheese section was pretty impressive. They had a lot of varieties. Nothing was too budget friendly, but there was a large variety, which I do really appreciate. I thought a cheese and crackers moment would be fun this week, so I went ahead and picked out a cheese to go with my little pita crackers. I chose the Trader Joe's cheddar and Gruyere together in one cheese. That seemed very interesting to me. I do love a cheddar and I do love a Gruyere, so why not put them together? I thought that was interesting. This was $4.49. It's for 0.6 pounds. So pretty average. I'm not complaining about that price for this extra fun cheese. Hopefully it will be delicious. I can definitely see like a movie night in the works here. Next, for $1.99, I picked up these sweet potato crackers. I thought they sounded really delicious, and I thought $1.99 was a pretty good deal. Next, for only $2.99, I did think this was a pretty good deal. I got this decaffeinated espresso coffee blend. This is for 16 ounces, product of Italy. I'm trying to get off the caffeine right now. I'm doing pretty good, but every now and then, I crave a little rich coffee moment, so I thought this would be perfect. Yeah, I thought this was a really good deal. Next, for $1.25, I got some buttermilk. This is a quart. That's a pretty decent deal. I mean, it's not great, but it's not bad. My little one really wanted to bake a cake today, and one of my favorite recipes calls for buttermilk, so I just grabbed it there so we could bake today. Next, for $3.29, I picked up the spicy Mexican-style riced cauliflower with tomatoes, tricolor, bell peppers, and jalapenos. I thought that that just sounded really good, but again, pretty expensive for like a frozen vegetable, you know? However, it is something that you can't get anywhere else. That's what I'm kind of finding, is that while things are pretty pricey at Trader Joe's, a lot of the things are things you can't get anywhere else. So while I probably wouldn't go there for like everyday groceries, every once in a while to get some sort of like out of the ordinary items, I can see why people like it. Next, for $3.99, I picked up this hot cocoa mix. There are 10 envelopes in here, which I think is a pretty good deal. The ones I bought, like the Swiss Miss from Dollar Tree, they're 6 for $1. So this is a little bit more expensive, but my sister told me that it's like the best hot cocoa. And you know, I'm gonna give that a try. If she says so, I gotta try it. I gotta find out for myself. I love hot cocoa. Next, for $1.99, I picked up some white cheddar popcorn. I love popcorn, it's one of my favorite snacks. I like the Aldi brand. I think it's a similar price, but the Aldi bag is a lot larger. But I thought I would just give it a try. It looked good. And $2 for a snack is still like, you know, a pretty decent deal. All right, next, for $9.99, this is definitely not something I would normally buy. These are delicious Italian chocolates. And I got these for my best friend, Mary Ellen, to give to her for Christmas. We went to Rome when we were young together over Christmas one year, just the two of us, and it was like totally a ton of fun. And these were some chocolates that we would eat there, and I had not seen them anywhere locally before, so it really kind of surprised me that Trader Joe's, of all places, had these delicious Italian chocolates. And I know she will totally appreciate the nostalgia of these Italian chocolates from our youth. Next, for $2.69, I got some spicy jollof rice. I've always wanted to try jollof rice, and this seemed like an easy way to sort of give it a try. I know that probably real, authentically made jollof rice is probably much better than this packet. However, I thought this would be a good way to just kind of give it a try and like see what it's like. It's got dried tomatoes, onions, and garlic. A little bit pricey for a tiny pack of rice. I mean, you could buy a huge thing of rice at the Dollar Tree, so I realize a little more expensive, but because it has all the spices in it and it's like pre-sort of seasoned, I thought that it's not a terrible deal. If you like jollof rice, what should I serve with it? All right, next for $5.49. It just seems like a lot to me. It's probably not technically, but it seemed like a lot to me. I got this bag of Kung Pao tempura cauliflower. I think that sounded really good, especially I'm not a big meat eater. I do eat like poultry, but I don't eat pork or beef. And so I love the idea of like tempura-ing a vegetable, and like that sounds really good. I think that's really steep for, again, this is essentially a frozen vegetable. That does seem like kind of a lot. Next, for $4.99, I picked up some lobster ravioli. This is definitely not something I would normally buy, but it's kind of like, you know, when at Trader Joe's, buy the things. And it's got this great color, it's all striped. Aldi will come out with their like special raviolis every once in a while. But I thought it looked good, and I thought $5 isn't a terrible deal. There's two servings in here, so this might be like a fancy little date night for my husband and I in, and I'm sure it's a lot cheaper than if we were to buy lobster ravioli at a restaurant, and it's probably just as good. So gotta figure out like the best sauce. Usually I make my own sauce when it comes to that kind of stuff, but I'm sure we'll figure that out. Next, for $2.99, we have another fun frozen item. This is cauliflower gnocchi. I've always wanted to try a cauliflower gnocchi. I've seen like recipes to make it yourself, but that seems like too difficult. So yeah, I thought it looked fun. They had a lot of different gnocchis there. They had sweet potato. They had like ones that were like stuffed with stuff. My sister got like one that was like stuffed with sauce and cheese, which I thought was pretty cool, but I was most intrigued by the cauliflower variety, so that's which one I selected. Next, for $3.99 a piece, I picked up three of these mini almond biscottis. These are actually going to be stocking stuffers. We like to do something small for every person in the family on Christmas Eve for everyone to open, so like my little bubble, my parents and everything. And I got all like the ladies in the family got these little mini coffee things, and I thought these would go well with them. I found a lot of great like stocking stuffer ideas at Trader Joe's, so if you're looking for like snacky type things to give your family, they really got it down with the snacks. Next, I picked up two grinders. This one has sea salt, this one has black peppercorns. This was $1.99, this was $2.29. I just thought it would be better. I think most cooking is just slightly elevated when you crack your own peppers and you grind your own sea salt, and it was really affordable, so I picked up a pair. All right, next I got, for $1.79 a piece, I picked up these grass-fed and finished beef sticks. One is original, one is jalapeno. These are gonna go in my husband's stocking. He loves beef jerky and beef sticks and that kind of stuff. And since I don't eat beef, we never have it in the house. So I thought these would be the perfect little thing to tuck right in his stocking. He will definitely like them. Next, for $3.99, oof, for a loaf of bread, I can't believe I paid that much. But it sounded so good. This is a sprouted wheat sourdough bread. I love a sprouted loaf. They have one at Aldi, but it's pretty small, and I'm the only one that like kind of eats it, so I don't buy it very often. But since this was a sourdough, which everyone in the house is a fan of sourdough, I really wanted to give it a try. I've never seen a sprouted sourdough before, so that is something that was kind of different. While expensive, I'm still excited about trying. Next, for $10.99, this is the most expensive thing I purchased today. I got these raw Argentinian red shrimp. I love Argentinian shrimp. They are so good. Every once in a while, I'll pick a bag up at Meijer. I thought $11 was a pretty decent deal for the amount that came in here. And these are something we have every once in a while. A lot of times we'll do like a fancy seafood or really delicious shrimp for New Year's. And since they're frozen, I can keep them in the freezer and we'll just see when the time comes. But New Year's Eve, a lot of times we do something like this. So I thought while I was there, I might as well grab them. Next, another interesting looking frozen item. I got this seafood stew, a blend of seafood in a hearty tomato sauce. It looked really good. And this was $5.99, so a little bit pricey, $6, but there are 2 servings. So $6 for like a good dinner. You know, that's an easy thing for Gianni and I to have for dinner with maybe like a baguette or something on the side, some good crusty bread. Honestly, that's not that expensive, you know, for a seafood meal. I'll take it, as long as it's delicious. We'll find out, I guess. Next, I have another stocking stuffer here. These are JoJo's sandwich cookies. Chocolate and peanut butter cookies in a peanut butter coating with a chocolate drizzle. These are gonna go in my husband's stocking. He loves chocolate and peanut butter together. That's like one of his favorite combos, so I know he'll like these. Next, for $1.99, I picked up this organic polenta. I love polenta. We don't have it that often, but when I do, I'm always reminded of how delicious and easy it is. This might be good with some of those Argentinian shrimp grilled on top of it. This might be good like sliced and grilled with the seafood soup. Polenta really is quite versatile, and it's just something I don't think about. We always go for rice or pasta when polenta is a perfectly good option. Next, for $3.99, I picked up this 2-pound bag of Brussels sprouts. I found their fresh foods weren't like really incredibly priced. We normally get most of our produce from a subscription box to Imperfect Foods. However, the Brussels sprouts were quite a bit cheaper than they were in our box this week, so I went ahead and just got them here. All right, next we gotta talk seasonings, because I got quite a few really good ones. I put out on my Instagram, on my stories, that I was going to Trader Joe's, and I asked everyone, if you, like, what's your favorite thing at Trader Joe's? Nearly everyone said spices. So, and it did not disappoint. I do have some of the everything but the bagel seasoning. My sister got me that last time she was at Trader Joe's, so I already have some of that stocked up, because that is a classic and a good one. But for $1.99, I got this za'atar, I hope I'm saying that correctly, seasoning. It's a blend of toasted sesame seeds, thyme, marjoram, coriander, oregano, chickpea flour, sea salt, sunflower oil, lemon oil. It sounds really good. And my sister also loves it. So yeah, she's a pretty good cook. I'll trust her. So I grabbed some of that. Next, for $2.29, I picked up some smoked paprika. Aldi never has the smoked paprika. They have regular paprika. And I've just found that if it's not smoked, then there's really no point in putting it in anything. It doesn't have enough flavor. It's the smokiness that makes the paprika great, so I was happy to find that. Next, for $2.99, I got the Mushroom & Company multi-purpose umami seasoning blend. I am so excited to add this to everything. I love mushrooms. I love umami flavor. This is very much exciting for me, so that was definitely one I was excited to grab today. Next, I got an everything but the elote seasoning blend. So it's salt, chili pepper, cheese, chipotle, and cumin. This is definitely like a taco style seasoning, but way better. My sister swears by this one too, so I can't wait to try this in our next sort of like Mexican inspired dish. But I'm actually excited to put it on corn, obviously. And the last spice I got for $2.99 is just called Cheesy Seasoning Blend. I eat popcorn all the time. This is definitely for me to put on my popcorn. I hope it's good. It probably is. I trust the Trader Joe's spices a lot. So, but you know, it says you can put it on vegetables and pasta too, but we know I'm putting it on my popcorn. Next, for $2.69, I picked up this little bottle of chili sesame oil. That sounds so good. We eat a lot of stir fry and stuff like that. Any sort of like vegetables we have left over in the fridge, we'll throw it in a pan to do some stir fry, and we often use sesame oil, but chili sesame oil sounded so good. So yeah, I think we have a couple leftover bell peppers right now, and probably, you know, whatever we end up at the end of the week, we're gonna toss it with some of this in a pan, and it's gonna be good. Next, for $1.79, I picked up some fresh thyme. I have a specific recipe that I picked this up for, and $1.79 I think is a really good deal. Next, for $2.19, I picked up these soft and juicy mangoes. My kids love these, and honestly, they taste just like candy. Aldi does have a dried mango, but they're not as delicious as these, and I think it's probably because these are really covered in sugar, and that's probably why. But yeah, I picked these up for the kids. They're gonna love them. And the last thing I got for $4.49 is this cod, like frozen meal with ratatouille and rice. It looked pretty good. Honestly, I got it because this would be like an easy lunch for me. I do usually like cook all my meals from scratch, you know. I have no problem, you know, cooking a salmon for lunch and whatnot. But every now and again, it's nice to have something that's just already portioned out and in the freezer and ready to go. So I thought I would give this a try. Not sure when I'm gonna end up eating it, but it'll be in the freezer for when I'm ready. All right, you guys, and that's all the stuff I got at Trader Joe's. And you guys, I spent $124.58. That is a lot. I will say, you know, I got the $10 chocolates for my friend, and I got the $10 shrimp, but still, that's a lot of money for the amount of groceries that I bought here. I definitely will not make it a regular thing going to Trader Joe's, especially because most of the stuff here I got was like frozen stuff, and like I didn't get a lot of like staples, like milk, eggs, things like that. I didn't get a lot of staples there. So I definitely think it's more of like a once in a while thing just to get some of the more like different things you don't normally get, and probably just to get the spices, because honestly the spices are great. I do see why it is a worthwhile stop to make every once in a while, but yeah, it won't be a regular thing for me, I don't think. A little too expensive. Let me know, how do you feel about Trader Joe's? Is there stuff you like specifically go there to get? Is there something that I missed that I need to try? Because, you know, this will happen again one day, I'm sure. Me and my sister will go again. So let me know what your favorite thing at Trader Joe's is. Did I buy anything that you love? Are you excited for me to try any of it? I'd love to hear what you have to say. And of course, come on back for more. I post 2 new videos a week. I'd love to have you. So subscribe if you haven't already. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye!